entertainment, exclusive interviews.
Love it. I hear the junkyard dog. I'm like, we're about to go to work. It's about that time.
Things got a little hotter in the bedroom now.
Oh my God, we're having sex like every day.
This is Isaiah John from Snowfall on FX, and you're watching Tony Alive.
We're about to move into the big leagues.
The gritty LA drama Snowfall is back.
I know what you've been doing, Franklin. You're welcome home when you stop.
How am I supposed to trust you?
You're being a little bit paranoid.
I'm a black man in America. Damn it, hell yeah, I'm paranoid.
Damson Idris returns as young street entrepreneur Franklin Saint on the hunt for money, power, and influence during the infancy of the 1980s crack cocaine epidemic in Los Angeles. Idris, along with Carter Hudson, Isaiah John, executive producer Dave Andron, and 350 faithful viewers, hit the Atlanta premiere of Season 2 and a Q&A hosted by media personality Big Tigger.
Atlanta takes the international spotlight this weekend as the Miss Universe pageant touches down in the city. Tyler Perry Studios has already set the stage for the official live broadcast happening Sunday night at 7 p.m. on Fox. But tonight, it officially begins in downtown Atlanta with the preliminary competition. Now, as you can see, tons of fans have already started lining up. They're coming inside, trying to get a glimpse of the contestants, 90 beautiful women from all corners of the globe. But the question is, who will take that $5 million crown and become Catriona Gray's successor? All right, what's your name?
My name is Oliver. I'm from Manila.
Where and who? You're from Manila.
Yeah.
You just told me that. Who do you think is going to win?
Definitely, it's going to be Philippines, Gazini.
My name is Antonio.
Where are you from?
I'm from Honduras.
Who do you think is going to win Miss Universe?
I hope Brazil.
Brazil?
Yes.
That's your favorite?
Yes, it is.
All right, we'll see what happens. What about you? What's your name? Oh, you know English? A little bit. Do you know who you want to win?
Mexico.
Mexico.
What's your name? Alexis Gonzalez.
Where are you from?
United States, Charlotte, North Carolina.
Who's your favorite? Who's going to win?
USA, Chesley Chris, definitely going to win.
All right. And what about you? What's your name?
Right here, Montez Roman from Charlotte, North Carolina. Here supporting Chesley Chris, Miss USA.
All right, you guys. As you can see, the stage is set. The preliminary competition is about to begin. Let's take a look inside. You see all these people. Everyone's representing their country. And again, as you can see, it is insane in here. Will it be Philippines? Will it be Mexico? Will it be Brazil? Will it be Miss USA? Let's go a little bit closer.
They're saying that this is the most important election ever. And looking at the stats, it seems like the stats from day one of early voting, that sentiment is being felt throughout the city. We set a record turnout, which I'm excited about, and we want to keep that momentum going. A lot of people are voting for the first time, and we want to make sure that you have all of the information you need to facilitate the process. We could start with you on the importance of early voting, Mayor Bottoms, and then Ms. Nancy, if you could tell us about some of the polling locations, that would be great.
So thank you so much for doing this. This is so exciting. You're absolutely right. This is the most important election of my lifetime. I'm probably a little older than everybody on the call, but I can, but I'm owning it.
Not by that much, Ms. Mayor.
I got you beat, Mayor, by that.
When we were invited to come and get a behind the scenes look at one of the world's largest productions, we jumped right on it. Walking through the Fox, you could feel the energy. A magical experience was in store for sure. A night that would surely take our minds through a wonder-filled journey to find the Sugar Plum Fairy. But what it takes to pull this production off is nothing short of amazing.
You have to get these shoes.
Yeah.
These shoes are so cute. Like, every dancer's dream is to get a pair of these. When you get to this level, you're doing something.
Exactly.
The Atlanta Ballet's female dancers wear out more than 2,000 pairs of pointe shoes each season. A strong point indeed, which premier performer Nadia Mara says is hard on the feet.
It's brutal, right?
It's brutal. We still get blisters.
Research shows that in 2016, Americans alone spent $16 billion on cosmetic plastic surgery and minimally invasive procedures. Among the most popular, breast augmentation, liposuction, nose reshaping, tummy tucks, and butt enhancements. But a good doctor always knows.
I want to hold up some pictures, and I want you to
tell me, you know, because some people say, oh, I've never had anything done. And I want you to tell me in your opinion if you think yay or nay. Have they had some work done? Can you tell? Good job, not a good job, or what? Of course, we know who that is.
I would say, yes, there probably is some fat grafting done to that one.
Okay. We won't show. Same person.
Yes.
I saw a picture before all of this, and yes, I agree with you.
And, you know, people will say, well, you know, take an x-ray of my butt. I didn't get it. Well, if you take an x-ray of your butt and you've had fat grafting, it's going to look just like fat.
How important is this film considering the climate that we're in right now today?
No, I think it's very important. Like I was saying, you know, I think we need to sort of, I think the movie kind of brings people together. I mean,
first of all, congratulations. 2 Emmys.
Yeah.
This film, they're already saying that you could win an Oscar off of it. How does that make you feel?
You know what? Listen, it would be good company to be in. My man Mahershala Ali, who I love and adore, we went to school together.
So sucked in. I was like, what happened? What is this? There's so much forgiveness that's going to take place. What are we going to be forgiving each other for? What happens? I know you can't give it all away.
Yeah.
Kind of set the page for us a little bit.
Take it, big dog. Go.
You know, they've been pushing buttons. Everybody's been pushing buttons on me for years. I'm up in here now.
I know, that's right.
4.1 okay. With y'all in the morning. Kiss 104,
can't
baby.
Stop the movement.
Can't stop it.
But one beautiful thing that did come out of that whole relationship is your granddaughter, Dreamy.
Yes.
So what's it like?
Dreamy is something else. I met Dreamy. Of course, I saw her when she was born. Mm-hmm. And I allowed the Kardashians to see her being born.
That's right. You allowed it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she did.
That's right. She pulled right.
She really did.
Yeah. And Jenner, she, mm-hmm. she said thank you or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Now, you're talking about Chris or Caitlin with...
You know what?
I just asked a question. Very honest question.
Well, a couple
it
of
came from
too.
An honest place.
Yay, about
them.
That would too,
be
right?
Chris.
That, yeah, that's
but it could have been Caitlin.
Yeah, it could have.
Okay.
No, but no, it was Chris.
Hey, Toby, speaking of your retirement, there's so many things you can do. Like, it's not beautiful, whether it's that 81.8, your 5 championships, thousands upon thousands of career points. What is it about yourself that you're most proud of that sticks out most to you?
I would say just sticking with it. You know, it's not tough times.
Good evening, Atlanta. I'm Satonia with your CW 69 News Update. There are no signs yet of progress by President Obama and House Republicans in their talks to avert the fiscal cliff. Democrats and Republicans are stuck on tax hikes for the wealthy and ways to cut federal spending. The two sides are still talking.
Waking up with a slack. A man is behind bars this morning facing charges of kidnapping and rape. Tony Williams' first appearance in court on Tuesday. Investigators say Williams was arguing with his girlfriend when he threatened to kill her. It's an historic neighborhood, but some say sometimes it looks more like Skid Row. People living in Gainesville's Duck Pond area are starting to complain about trash, loud noise, and homeless folks camping out of all places, the headquarters of the Alachua County Housing Authority. First sign of macular degeneration may be a need for more light when you do close-up work. The condition usually develops gradually, but may sometimes progress rapidly, leading to severe vision loss in one or both eyes.
We are on location at Michonne's. Now I have to ask you, when you came in, was Michonne's that big of a nightmare? Did you feel like you had like a lot of work you had to do, or was it, you know?
Good question. First off, they'd lost their way, I think, really.
When Patsy Ramsey made the phone call to 911, where she's reporting that her daughter was missing, and there was a ransom note, blah, 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 mm-hmm. She immediately rushed off the phone. But here's the problem. As you all know, of course, by now, 20 years later, she went to hang up the phone, but she didn't hang it up.
Oh, my God.
Patsy? I'll just say, in my own personal opinion, I would not rule the brother out, mm-hmm. because he did admit to Dr. Phil that there was a situation in which he hit that little girl with a golf club.
The red carpet activities are underway. We just talked to Erica Ashe, actress. You may have seen her in Scary Movie 5. So beautiful. And her dress was amazing. And man, it's just a little bit of what we're going to see today. It's crazy. All the big wigs and the Atlanta insiders, we're right here giving you the inside.
Antonia Moore from B103, of course, this is such a huge event.
It is huge, and of course, a lot of talent right here in Atlanta, and some of their top 20 performers that make it to L.A. come out of Atlanta, and we've had some season winners out of Atlanta, so this is it. This is awesome.
She makes a very good point.
All right.
right, so basically all of these people are here today to press their luck in the world of professional dancing. Years and years of training and experience, it all comes down to what they do today on that stage. They'll get a couple of minutes to go in and show the producers exactly what they have.
Hello there, Roxy Diaz, Sutonia Live on the red carpet.
I'm Roxy Diaz and you're watching Sutonia Live.
Come see what everyone's talking about.
Egypt.
Sutonia Live.